Hi, I'm Zach Parsons, licensed acupuncturist. I'm going to be showing you the side variation of the one-handed needle turn. This is a video posting for The Silver Needle, a blog for practitioners and students of palpation-based acupuncture. For more information on this and other techniques, please visit me online at thesilverneedle.blogspot.com. Let's get to it. The one-handed needle turn begins with the tube cradled loosely in the third, fourth, and fifth fingers. There is about a quarter of an inch distance between the end of the tube and the lateral edge of your third finger. Your needle is held in the thumb and index finger. Both fingers are extended straight, and the needle is pointed in the direction of the thumb. The side variation of the one-handed needle turn looks like this. It is a very fast way to take the needle from outside of the tube, load it into the tube, and bring it into a side grip, which is useful for many acupuncture insertions, all the while maintaining the sterility of the needle. Here it is shown more slowly. The side variation begins with a lateral movement of the thumb. You roll the handle of the needle, and you continue to slide the needle up the index finger so that it rests on top of the finger at the base of the pad. The index finger crooks a little bit so that it has something to rest the needle on. Your thumb rotates so that it faces in the same direction as the index finger, and you extend both downward. You are now in the same position you began with, except that the needle is at a 90-degree angle. Bending the thumb and the index finger, load the handle halfway into the tube, and grasp the point where the handle and the tube come together. Up until this point, your wrist should not have moved. It is only at this point that you turn your hand over. By closing the fourth and fifth fingers, but primarily through the action of the fourth finger, you are going to place the free end of the tube at a spot just below the web margin of your third and fourth fingers. The needle pivots because you are gripping with your thumb and index finger at the point where the handle and the tube come together, and you are focusing your intention on that spot. You slide the thumb halfway down the tube so it provides some stability, and it is only the lateral pressure of the index finger that keeps the needle from falling out. Release that pressure, and the needle falls into the tube. Place the second and third fingers on the side of the tube and remove the thumb. At this point, you're going to want to check in with the angle of your forearm. The angle of your forearm has to be less than 45 degrees and should be less than 30 degrees to make this an easy technique. The reason is that the next step, you're going to be opening your fingers and allowing gravity to pull the needle out of the tube. If you have a very acute angle with your forearm relative to the floor, the needle will fall out too quickly and fall past your thumb and onto the floor before you can catch it. The way we catch it is we take our thumb and we slide it across so that it contacts the base of the tube and also a small amount of the handle that is protruding. Maintaining two points of grip, you have your third and fourth fingers holding the sides of the tube, and you have your thumb on the base of the tube, you open your hand, stretching the tube away from you and allowing gravity to let half of the needle handle fall out, at which point you catch it with the lateral pressure of the thumb. This lateral pressure of the thumb is going to change direction a little bit in the next step because you're going to roll your thumb across the needle handle, so that it ends up on the pinky side as opposed to the index finger side. At this point, you're going to maintain that grip between the third and the fourth fingers, and you're going to use it as the pivot of a lever. Focusing on the place where the handle and the tube come together, you're going to press with your thumb up towards your index finger, causing the needle and the tube to lever upwards. And at this point, it is a simple matter to simply grasp the needle and the handle, and the tube with the index finger. It is now in a side grip. You may bring it to your insertion point and you may use it. There are 11 checkpoints in the side variation of the one-handed needle turn. If you are having difficulty at any point in this technique, please note what checkpoints you're having the trouble at and go to the blog at thesilverneedle.blogspot.com, where you will find a written description of everything you've seen here. I'll show you the technique now with just the checkpoints highlighted. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. I hope you enjoyed the video. The one-handed needle turn is an excellent technique and well worth practicing. To read more about it, view other videos, and so much more, please join me at thesilverneedle.blogspot.com, because health is better when it's shared. I'll see you there.